Okay, so we talked about finite complement topology, right? Now we have the following definition. Dediğim gibi eğer anlamadığınız bir şey varsa beni hemen durdurup sorun o anda. Çünkü yani üstüne bir şeyler geldi mi daha da anlaşılması zor olur. O anda şey yapalım, üzerinden geçelim. Okay, now we will describe how we compare topologies. I already mentioned stronger topology, strongest topology, weakest topology, but let's see precisely what we mean. Okay, now suppose that tau and time are two topologies on a set X. Okay. If prime is, let's say, has, if it contains tau, then we say that tau prime is finer or stronger, okay, stronger than tau. Okay. Also, we say that, or equivalently diyeyim, equivalently, we say that tau is coarser tau prime. So tau prime is finer than tau. Tau is coarser than tau prime. Right? Okay. Of course, you know, according to this definition, thus, you know, the topology, tau is defined as the power set of X. This collection of all subsets is really strongest topology on X. So the discrete topology is the strongest topology. Okay. All right. Okay. We also here say weaker. Okay. Coarser or weaker? Şöylesin. Tamam. Alright. Now we will see so-called basis for a topology. You have to either list all the subsets, open subsets of the topology, or you have to give a definition which you know can be checked in you know practically. For example, you know, for the standard topology on R, the topology we have seen in calculus. How do we call a subset open? We say that a subset is open if, right, we call u open if any element in x has some r positive, so that x minus r x plus r lies in u, right? In this case, we call a subset open. So either we list all the open sets or we give a rule which can be checked, whether a subset satisfies this or not. This way we can define a topology. Of course, defining a topology by listing all the subsets is not practical because probably the collection of open sets is uncountable, so you cannot just list them easily. Instead, we will give a definition like this. We will try to give a definition for being open, and this open sets like this one will be called basic open sets, or we will call them basis elements of the topology. Okay, so what I will do next is kind of generalization of these open intervals whose unions gives us the open sets in R, right? And we will have the same thing for a general topological space. Yani reel eksende open seti tarif etmek için open subset intervalları kullanıyoruz. Genel bir topolojik uzayda da open setleri listelemek için, tarif etmek için tabii ki orada open interval yok. Onun yerine open interval'ın yerine geçen işte basis elemanı dediğimiz open subsetleri kullanacağız. Şimdi onun tarifini yapalım. If x is a set, basis for a topology of x is a collection beta of subsets of x, which will be called basis elements, such that they satisfy the following two conditions. What are they? For each x in x, there is at least one basis element. There is at least one basis element B containing x. Okay, so for each x, there is one B, so that this x belongs to B. The second one is this, is the following. If x belongs, belongs to the intersection of two basis elements, B1 and B2, then there is a third basis element, element B3, so that B3 contains X and B3 is contained in the intersection. So if you have a collection of subsets satisfying these two conditions, then we call that collection a basis for a topology. So for which topology we don't know, but we will state now which topology is that. So this definition is independent of topological space, okay? And if you have a basis for a topology, then this basis defines a topology. We will see that now. If B is a basis for a topology, so it satisfies these two conditions, then we define the topology tau generated by B as follows. So a topology becomes the topology here. And let's see what are the open sets of that topology. A subset U of X is set to be open. In X, in other words, U belongs to the topology. If for each X in U, there is some B in B, so that X is in B and B lies in U. So this is exactly the definition we used to define open sets in the real line, right? Where this basis elements were just open intervals. Okay. Well, note that each basis element is itself an element of tau, right? Each basis element is also an open subset. No. Where did I forget that? So we will call a set open. So I am defining, suppose B is a collection satisfying these two conditions. Then using this basis, I define a topology. Defining a topology means defining open sets. So I am telling you which subsets are open. And we say that a set is open if what happens? If for any element, for any point in that set U, if there is a basis element, so that basis element belongs to B and B lies inside U, then we call U an open set. Okay, so my open sets are these. Oh, here. You mean here? No, because we don't know. Okay. Okay, sorry. Open in X. Yes. Dışarıdan bu ses geliyor mu size de? Ağaç kesiyorlar galiba da onun sesi geliyor. Size geliyor mu? Tamam. Bana bayağı geliyor da ben bir kapatayım şu camı. Tamam. Now is it okay now? Alright, so you have to compare this again, as I said earlier, with the standard topology on real line and open intervals. And actually, I'll do more examples now here. Okay, let's see some examples. Evet, onu da söyleyeceğim şimdi. İsterseniz şuraya da size bir exercise bırakayım. Yani şurada tarif edilen şey gerçekten bir topoloji. Check that tau is indeed a topology. Okay. Yani so I define open sets this way and one has to check that this really defines a topology on X, okay? But let me give some examples. For example, consider the real line and let's say beta is this collection, open intervals AB. AB are some numbers. So my beta consists of open intervals. Okay. Okay. Now we claim that is basis for a topology. Okay. So we have to check two things. What are the two things we have to check? First of all, each point in X should lie inside a basis element. Well, let X in R a point. Then, of course, X lies inside this open interval. It is an open interval. It's an element of beta. So this is checked. Second, if X is a point and if this lies and if X lies inside in the intersection of two basis elements, so one basis element and another basis element, then I have to find a third basis element so that X belongs to that basis element and that basis element lies inside this intersection. Of course, I can just do this. So, well, note that either I have something like this, AB, CD, or I have CD, AB, and X is either here or here. So, which interval should I choose? Okay, I should choose okay, minimum of no, the larger okay. So let okay, E to be the maximum of A and C and F to be the minimum of B and D. Okay? B and D. Then, okay.
Clearly, E is less than F. Why is that? Because both, so A is bir dakika. Böyle olsaydı AB CD olsaydı yine minimumu şey maksimumunu alacaktım. C olacaktı. Evet, yok, fark etmiyor. Gene doğru çıkıyor. Şimdi EF'den küçüktür. Neden? Yani E çünkü ya A ya da C. If it is A, then E is less than B. And if this is the case, then E is less than D. Şimdi bir dakika. Aslında şey var tabii. Bunlar kesiştiği için şimdi not that X A B intersection C D değil mi? Dolayısıyla da and hence A is less than X and C is less than X and this is less than B and this is less than D. Yes. Therefore, maximum of A and C, E, which is maximum of A and C is still less than X. And this is still less than minimum of B and D, which is F. In particular, we see what? So, we see what? X is in this interval E and F. Because X is larger than this and less than this. And moreover, E is yes. And this is inside AB because E is less than or equal to A. Evet. Yok. E is larger than or equal to A. Yes. And less than or equal to B. Similarly, E is larger than or equal to C and less than or equal to D. Therefore, we have this. So, I have found a third interval which contains X and lies here. So that the second condition is also satisfied. Hence, this is a basis for a topology on X. What is that topology? So this is the topology whose open sets are the subsets of real line so that any point in that subset contains an interval contained in that subset. So so if U is an open set defined or not defined, generated by B, this collection, then for any x in x, there is some r positive, so that no, there is some interval AB in the collection, so that x is in AB and that lies inside U, right? That's the definition of the topology generated by B. But this means what? Any element of U contains an open interval that lies inside U. This is just the standard definition of open set in R, right? However, this is just the standard definition of being open set in R, right? From the calculus. This topology is also called the standard topology on R, which we denote as R standard. So when I write R standard, I mean the underlying set is R and the open sets are the usual open sets. What we mean by usual open sets? A subset is open if and only if every point in that set contains an interval, is contained in some interval which is contained in that set. Okay, all right. So open intervals therefore defines or forms a basis for a topology. Actually, it is just the standard topology. Another example şuraya da tanımı yaptık ya, hani şurada bak. We define the topology tau generated by B as follows. Yani B tarafından generate edilmek şu. Bir subset'e open diyeceğim. Yani bir topoloji kuruyorum. O zaman sana open setlerinin neler olduğunu söylemem lazım. Tanımı şu. Bir subset'e open diyeceğim. Eğer şu varsa, o subsetten aldığım her elemanın etrafında bir tane baz elemanı bulacağım. Öyle ki o baz elemanı da U'nun içinde kalacak. Tamam mı? Eğer böyleyse o sete open diyeceğim. Ve open setleri O olan topolojiye de işte generated by B diyeceğim. Anladın mı? Tamam. Şimdi bakın. Bunu bir adım öteye götürelim. Şimdi R'deki recall the standard topology on R2. Ne standart topoloji R2'de? Bir kümeye open diyoruz. Yani metrik uzay olarak düşünün. Considered as a metric space with the Euclidean metric. Neydi bir open set? U is called open. only if for any point in U there is some what R positive, so that P is in the ball with center P, radius R, and that lies inside R2, U. So we call a subset open if what happens if whenever I am given a point, I have to find a radius, positive radius, so that this ball with center P and radius R lies inside U. If this is the case, then we call U to be open. Well, there are two obvious bases for this topology. One basis is two bases for this topology are as follows. İki tane farklı basis vereceğim. Bir tanesi beta 1. What are these? These are just balls. P is in R2. R is a positive number. And this B, where we define BPR to be this. Okay, so this is the set of all points. So that the Euclidean distance P to Q is less than R. Okay, this is the Euclidean distance. We call it D2, I guess. So D2, okay, A, B, C, D. Ya da şöyle diyeyim. X1, Y1, X2, Y2. So what is the Euclidean distance? It is this one. X2 minus X1 squared, Y2 minus Y1 squared. So this corresponds usual balls, right? Usual balls. However, I can also consider the following. So this is the D2 ball, D1 ball, P is in R2, R is positive, and D2, D1 ball is this, the D1 metric, sorry. Maximum of neydi bu? X1, X2, Y1, Y2. Buradaki ball nedir? Buradaki ball da şu olacak. Bir tane P merkezli ve R yarıçaplı yuvar alırsanız, so in this case balls are like this. Okay. So this distance at most R. Okay. Okay. This collection is also a basis for the same topology. And so this means that these two collections, these two bases generates the same topological space, which is just the Euclidean topology on R2. And one easy way to see this is the following. You see, whenever I have a basis element of the first kind from beta 1, I can find a basis element of the second kind contained in the first one. And this means that the topology generated by squares is stronger than the topology generated by the balls. And similarly, whenever I have a square, I have a circle in it. And this means that the topology generated by B1 is stronger than the topology generated by B2. Okay? And therefore, you know, the topology generated by B1 and topology generated by B2 are the same because they are both stronger than each other. Therefore, they have to be equal. Okay. So. Okay. Note that B1 and B2 generate the same topology on R2, the standard topology. Okay. Okay, şurada evet şöyle bir lemma var, onu yapayım. En azından state edeyim. Let X be a set. Let beta be a basis. Be a basis for a topology tau on X. So the topology generated by B is tau. Then tau equals the collection of all unions of elements of basis. So if a topology is generated by a basis B, then actually the open sets are nothing but arbitrary unions of elements of B. So in our case, if you consider the standard topology on R, we said that open intervals is a basis for that topology. So this means that open subsets of the real line are just unions of open intervals. And this is, of course, something we already know, right? Set is the union of open intervals. Proof of this is very easy, but let's just do it so that we understand the definitions better. So let U be an open set. Open set of course, tau, the topology. Since beta is a basis, then for any x in U, there is some basis element bx in this collection, so that x is in bx and this lies inside U. Right? This is the definition of topology generated by a basis element. Okay, but this means what? Then x, which is just what? U. U is nothing but the union of 1-point sets contained in U. But each 1-point set is contained in Bx because x belongs to Bx. Therefore, this union belongs to this union. However, each Bx is contained in U. Therefore, their union lies in U. So what I obtained is this. U is a subset of this. This is a subset of this. And this is a subset of U. Well, this means, hence, U is just the union of the basis elements. So what we see is that any open set of the topology generated by B is a union of some elements of the basis. On the other hand, again, by the definition of topology generated by B, each basis element is open in tau, and their arbitrary unions. Their arbitrary unions are also open in X. So we proved the lemma then, because any open set is a union of basis elements and each basis element is open. Therefore, their arbitrary unions are open sets. Therefore, open sets are the same as arbitrary unions of basis elements. Okay, I guess this much is enough for today. I may stop at this point. Okay.